Hey there, guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 13. In the last episode, we cleared out the starboard weather deck of enemies and got all treasure balls on the Palamecia. On part of the Palamecia, I should say. And then we fought a boss. Two bosses, actually. And finally, the party was reunited after a long, long time. So now everyone's back together. You can now switch your battle team at any time. So I added Saz to the party because of his haste, synergist ability is going to come in handy. And yeah. So we're in the final stretch of the Palamecia. Now this is a big open area with lots of different ways you can take that lead to treasure balls and enemies. So if you want, go ahead and open up the map and you can get a look at your surroundings. Now as you can see, some of the areas are inaccessible right now. So in order to get there, you're going to have to look out for these terminals. Here you can press a switch and it'll extend the bridge like is shown here. And that's how you get from each platform to platform. Now before we go on, let me just show you guys my setup. The leader is Lightning and you can't change that right now. And then I have Saz and Fang. A quick look at the Paradigms. I have Relentless Assault, Cerberus, Decimation, Strategic Warfare, Bully, and Diversity. So after you've got your Paradigm set up with whatever battle team you're using, next let's quickly look at the equipment. For Lightning, I have the Gladius, Titanium Bangle, and Shaman's Mark. For Saz, I have the Procyons, Power Wristband, and Tungsten Bangle. Finally, for Fang, I have the Bladed Lance, Brawler's Wristband, and Tungsten Bangle. Once your characters are set up, go ahead and proceed down the first bridge. Now there are 8 treasure balls you can get here in about 9 or 10 different battles. So let's make our way to the first platform below and take out the enemies.
Nothing I can't handle.
After clearing out the enemies on the first platform, let's go ahead and set our active Paradigm for Decimation so that Saz can use his synergist role to cast haste on everybody. Then we can switch over to Relentless Assault. Alright. So after that, now at the first platform, go ahead and head over to the right side, or left side if you're going down the bridge, and press the button. This will extend a bridge over to the platform on the left, where you can open up a treasure ball for a Libroscope. After you got that, go ahead and return to the main platform and extend the bridge to the right. Now there's nothing over here, but if you want to go and fight a couple enemies, you can do so.
This'll be interesting. Time for another approach.
So as you can see, Saz's haste ability is really useful. And coming up soon in the game, I'll show you guys a way to get auto haste at the start of battle. It requires a little bit of grinding and a little bit of synthesizing and upgrading your accessories. But with a little bit of effort, it can be done. You get auto haste at the start of battle.
Keep the enemy off balance.
So I'll let you guys know whenever that's possible. We're still a little ways off though. But once you do get it, it makes the game go so much faster. And it makes the feel of the game a whole lot better and a lot more fun. Alright, so you can go ahead and extend another bridge. Further up. And at the very top left corner, you'll find a treasure ball that contains two rune bracelets. Which is resist magic by 10%. Now once you've got that, before you leave the platform, you should go ahead and activate the nearby terminal, so that you can connect all the platforms together. And I forgot to do that over here on the left as well. I almost passed up an item on you guys. Sorry about that. I forgot completely. Back where you found the first treasure ball with the libroscope, if you head back there, you can extend the bridge even farther back. And at the very top here, you'll find another treasure ball that you can open up for a pain dampener, which is resist pain by 30%. Alright, so while you're over here, let's go ahead and extend the bridge further down. And here, let's go ahead and descend and take care of the enemies on this platform. So we're on the far left-hand side of the area.
Back me up. Change of...
I don't understand why lightning doesn't cure Saz whenever he's in critical HP status. Instead, she cures herself. It makes no sense. That's really why I don't like lightning as a medic. What? And she doesn't even get Saz up with rays.
Stay calm.
Thanks.
I really don't like lightning as a medic. A lot of people like using her, but I don't find her very intelligent as a medic. I really don't. Like, look, she's healing herself instead of healing Saz.
Thanks.
even break a sweat.
At least Fang's doing work over there. She took them all out single-handedly. Fang's a beast. I wish I could say the same about Lightning in her medic role, but that was awful. While you're on the platform, go ahead and descend the nearby terminal to create a bridge down lower. Now, you may see a treasure ball down there, but before we get down there, let's go ahead and take care of the area that we're at. So go ahead and ascend the bridge leading to the right towards the central area. Now, if you move over here, you can take out more enemies.
Keep your mind on the battle. We can get through this. Another thing to take note of is the Psycom Reaver. He has 59,400 HP and he looks crazy. Also, half of his vulnerabilities are halved. And I was just getting started.
Switching to Cerberus when an enemy staggered means he ain't gonna last very long at all. Alright, once you clear out the area, go ahead and descend the next bridge. And then head over to the right and extend the bridge over to the right side of the area. here you can backtrack and get a treasure ball. That contains an Umbra, which is a new weapon for Snow. So if you want to check that out, go ahead. I go ahead and equip it because it's pretty good. It decreases his strength by 10, but it's got the improved ward, which really helps him out in his sentinel role, which is what Snow is primarily used for. Then go ahead and descend the bridge on the right side of the area. Now before going on, we're going to backtrack so we can descend a bridge in the central area. You want to make sure all the bridges are descended, that way that you can quickly travel from platform to platform if you ever need to backtrack. Alright, so once we've descended all the bridges, or extended all the bridges, that's the word I was looking for. I couldn't find the word. Let's go ahead and head down the central area. And clear out the enemies on the central path. Say bye bye. Cerberus is fantastic. And so is Haste. Two incentive chips for that battle. Very nice. Alright, so let's go ahead and descend the final. Or no, we got one more bridge in the middle to descend. And then let's descend the bridge over to the left. And finally, the one over to the right. Alright, so let's go ahead and clear out the enemies on the right-hand side before heading to the left. Collect a treasure ball. Out of my way!
Appreciate it.
Alright, so let's go ahead and extend the bridge on the right while we're over here. And now let's head over to the left-hand side to collect that treasure ball we saw a while back. Go ahead and open up the treasure ball on the left for 3,600 gil. And then extend the bridge on the left-hand side. Now let's go ahead and head down and mop up some enemies.
Time for another approach.
Alright, so after taking out the enemy on the left, go ahead and extend the final bridge on the left. And while we're over here, let's go ahead and run down the bridge we just extended on the far left, which is the final bridge of the left-hand side, and run to the end of the platform in order to find a treasure ball. And this contains a gold bangle. So let's go ahead and get that onto lightning right away because it increases maximum HP by 250. And then we can put the titanium bangle onto Fang because her HP is the second lowest. Alright, with all that taken care of, go ahead and backtrack. And we're going to head over to the middle path. Let's go ahead and extend the bridge. And let's wipe out the enemies on the center bridge.
We can win if we stay focused.
Oh, and we got wiped out. That's not good.
No.
Alright, for this middle battle, let's go ahead and switch the active paradigm to Relentless Assault. Because the Psycom, the main Psycom guy there, what's his name? Psycom Reaver, he just dispels haste. So there's really no point in even having haste on while in a fight with the Psycom Reaver. Because he'll just dispel it. It's very important to take note that the Psycom Reaver will dispel all of your buffs. So it's kind of pointless while in this battle to have Saz as a synergist. Alright, so after taking out the guys on the middle platform, go ahead and extend the final central bridge so that you can proceed to the destination marker. But before you do that, we have a couple more platforms we have to go visit. Alright, so let's extend the bridge leading to the right. Here we can mop up the enemies over here.
New strategy! Appreciate it. You asked for it.
Alright, so after taking care of them, go ahead and extend the final bridge on the right side of the area. And while we're over here, let's go ahead and descend it and head to the final platform so that we can get the treasure ball in the far right hand corner. And this contains a perfect conductor. Alright, so now you should have all the bridges extended. And if you do, your map will look something like this. Also, you should have all the treasure balls except one. So you can count them and make sure you got them all after this. For now, head back to the central area and descend the final central bridge. On the final platform, you'll find the save point to the left and the last treasure ball on the right. So go ahead and open the treasure ball for an ether's all. And then make sure you got everything. There should be a total of 8 treasure balls. Alright, and that's everything. Alright, so now before we head over to the boss battle, let's do a little bit of quick preparation. First of all, let's change our battle team to Lightning, Saz, and Vanille, because we're going to need a primary healer for this upcoming battle. Next up, let's talk about the equipment. Go ahead and equip Vanille with the Titanium Bangle to increase her HP, since she has fairly low HP. Alright, So now that that's taken care of, let's talk about some equipment. First off, you're going to want to put the gold bangle onto Lightning. And a rune bracelet, which resists magic by 10%, because this upcoming boss has powerful magic attacks. And for Vanille, go ahead and keep a titanium bangle on her and give her a rune bracelet. And if you want, you can buy one more gold bangle. Or one more titanium bangle. And go ahead and give that titanium bangle to Saz. And if you want, you can remove the brawler's wristband from Fang and give it to Saz to give him an extra strength boost. If I can find it here. Alright, that'll get Saz's strength up to about 200, which isn't too bad. Alright, so overlooking it all, we have Lightning with a Gladius, a gold bangle, and a rune bracelet. We have Saz with the Procyons, Brawler's wristband, and a titanium bangle. And we have Vanille with the rune healer staff. Let's go ahead and... she should be alright with the... Let's go ahead and keep that healer staff onto Vanille right now. But we're going to be switching it very soon. But for now, keep healer staff because she's very good. She's healing really good with the healer staff because it increases her cure. And a rune bracelet and titanium bangle. Alright, once you've made the necessary preparations on your accessories, let's finally check out the Paradigm deck. First of all, let's start out with Commando, Ravager. And then you want Ravager. Third, you're going to want Commando, Savitar. Fourth, you want Ravager, Savitar. And fifth, you want Medic, Ravager, Medic. And for the last Paradigm, let's go ahead and switch to Commando, Ravager, Medic. Alright, so again, you can check your Paradigms and make sure you got the right ones. We got Aggression, Tri-Disaster, Devastation, Smart Bomb, Perpetual Magic, and Diversity. Once you've got the right equipment and Paradigm set up, make sure you save your game and prepare for one of the hardest bosses in Final Fantasy XIII. So I'll see you guys next time wherever we confront this boss and see what really lies ahead.